Hey there, happy Friday. I hope you all have had a good week and are getting ready for a good weekend and hopefully able to enjoy some of this oddly unseasonably nice weather. A few things. I've returned all of the article approval assignments. Several of you have gotten notes from me that you need to switch one article or both, depending. Actually, I think only one in most all cases. If you got a poor grade, if you got anything lower than 100, that is probably the case. Make sure you're checking the comments on the assignments. I am updating grades for those of you who get your articles situated and email me about that. So please do that as soon as you have a chance. You need to make sure that you're working with the correct article for the next part of the assignment. Speaking of the next part of the assignment, I have asked you to choose a scholarly and popular article. Now, for this article evaluation, right now, we are only working with the scholarly article. Got it? Only working with the scholarly article. Let's review for a moment the differences between scholarly and popular articles. This was covered in readings and in your library activities this week. Scholarly articles are typically written for a specific academic audience. They will generally be peer-reviewed and appear in academic journals. You will typically have to access them through the library's databases. Speaking of which, I know there were some problems with accessing the library activities and accessing the summon search for some of you this week. All of that was handled yesterday, and you should have access to everything. If that is not the case, please let me know. I apologize for these issues. All of this worked absolutely fine last spring when I taught these courses. I refreshed everything, checked links, and then there were issues based on counties blocking particular websites. So I'm sorry that you had those problems. I did not foresee that happening. That said, I think everything is good. Access is restored. Academic articles. Typically, these are going to not have big flashy ads or pictures. They're going to have perhaps graphs and tables of information. They will cite sources. They will cite other scholarly sources. You will see very formal language. You will often see long titles. They will have an abstract. Now, with popular articles, these are the kinds of things that we find out on the general internet. So news articles, assorted posts, and that's not to say that they aren't sometimes reliable, but they're going to be written for a general audience. The information is not going to be as in-depth. The vocabulary is going to be simpler. They'll have often catchy, shorter titles. The language will be less formal. For instance, a scholarly article is going to talk about children, where a popular article will probably talk about kids, to give you an example. So pay attention to the language that's used. Pay attention to where you find those articles. Popular articles are often going to have ads. They'll appear on websites, news sites, etc. So keep that in mind. With our article evaluation, what you're going to be doing is what's called a rhetorical analysis. Essentially, you're going to be looking at how the writer delivers the information. It's important for you to realize you're not writing an article or an essay about the topic of the article. You are looking at how that writer reaches his or her audience, or writers. A lot of these will sometimes be written by multiple writers. So you're going to, for the next part of this assignment, focusing on the scholarly article, you're going to summarize that article briefly, and then you are going to analyze how the writer reaches the audience. Some things you could look at: the tone, the language, the organization, the depth of information, some of those characteristics of scholarly articles, and see whether this article lives up to the expectations of a scholarly article and whether it will reach its audience well. I gave you some questions on the assignment to help you with that. Now, if you jumped the gun and perhaps worked with your popular article already, hang on to that. You're going to need it for the next essay assignment, which will compare the two articles. Okay, so you haven't wasted any work. All right, hold on to it. Just a few other things. I'm still working on your ad evaluations. I have a lot of students, so it's taken me a little time. I'm trying to grade them in the order that I received them, and I will be working on them all afternoon until I leave. So I hope to have most of them back today. If you did not submit your ad evaluation to both the assignment and Turnitin links, please take care of that. If you see a grade of 1, that is the problem. I've also put that in the comments on the assignment. So please take care of that so I can get it graded. I know some of you have already fixed it. I will get around to your essays as quickly as I can. A couple of other things. Please, 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 when you email me, especially if it's about a grade issue or if you are giving me your new articles, if you had to change an article, always, always make sure that you include the section number in your email. That lets me find you in the class and fix your grades a lot more quickly. And then a last little housekeeping note. I know that for you all, Monday is a school holiday. So your work for next week, that summary and analysis is due on Tuesday. All right. That said, I am actually also going to be out of the office Monday. My daughter's daycare is closed and I will be home with her Monday. Having her to take care of is not conducive to me checking emails. So my office hours for Monday will be canceled. That said, any emails you send me, I'll do my best to tackle at the first opportunity. So that's about it. This ended up being a little bit longer of a video than I had anticipated. So sorry about that. But as always, if you have questions, send me an email. I hope you all have a wonderful weekend. I hope you enjoy your day off Monday. And I look forward to working with you again next week. Take care.